What's up, everybody, and welcome to another episode of Raudeza Reviews. I'm Raudeza. And before we get started, for all of you subscribers out there who, you know, presumably have mothers, I want to wish you a happy Mother's Day. So if you're celebrating today with your special lady, I know I will be later. Happy Mother's Day, guys. They really do a lot for us. Just a few programming updates and some updates on some products. Unfortunately, I just got the word from Big Bad Toy Store. MepToys, who was making the 148th scale Invid Scout and Shock Troopers, unfortunately, guys, it looks like that something happened with the manufacturer and they're not going to be producing those figures, which really sucks because they would have gone really awesome with the Cyclones that I reviewed earlier this year. I mean, it would have really been cool to have an updated version of the Invid Scout and the Shock Trooper, because unfortunately, it looks like, at least for the foreseeable future, guys, it's not going to happen. So if you were interested in those, make sure if you made any pre-orders with any of these companies that you check with them, because it looks like it's just not happening, guys, which is really sad. Now, in terms of the products themselves, I've got a huge backlog of things. I actually got overwhelmed with the amount of things that came into the studio, but I am going to get to them, including Pop-Up Parade's version of Cammy, Chun-Li, Faye Valentine, and Jet Black. Those are coming up, along with Jaime Lannister Season 8. And some Kotobukiya figures that I just got in. So a lot of stuff coming, guys. It's going to be really exciting. I'm really happy for all of you who have supported the channel. And we're going to keep it going because, unlike some people, my wife wasn't supporting me. So I can continue on with my reviews and my channel. Alright, guys. So as promised, this is the actual video that I was going to upload last week. But I got a little bit derailed by a crazy person. You guys know who I'm talking about. But I am definitely going to get to this one because I'm very excited. This thing is just so awesome, guys, so let's get into the review. Today we're going to be reviewing Kotobukiya's version of Optimus Prime, the Bishojo statue. Let's take a closer look. Two of my great passions in life. You take Transformers that I loved as a kid and Kotobukiya figures that I love as an adult, you smash them together and you get this beautiful ass statue. Guys, this is absolutely stunning. Just take a look at the head sculpt. I mean, it's absolutely amazing. I love the countenance and the face. The eyes are done so well. I actually like the crest that is clearly Optimus Prime. The hair sculpt looks fantastic. Color palette is amazing, guys. This is just one of the most beautiful Kotobukiya statues that I've ever seen. I mean, it just screams Transformers. Unbelievable, guys. I love the way that this came out. The midsection of this piece is probably my favorite, mostly because of the style and the art direction. The leather jacket looks great. That wet leather look with that brilliant red is striking. And then you have the contrast with that wonderful Autobot symbol, simply iconic at this point. But the focal point here is definitely the Autobot Matrix of Leadership. Just look at how detailed that is with that thick chain. Guys, they did a magnificent job here. I like the inner shirt and, of course, the midsection, which is showing the belly button. Very sexy. Guys, this is amazing. I love what they did here. The lower section of this piece is just as beautiful. You see a lot of hints of the icons and the throwbacks to the original Optimus Prime design. I especially love the trailer. The suitcase looks absolutely fantastic. The folds in the actual short shorts that she's wearing are really well done, along with the shading. But back to the trailer, guys. Just look at how awesome it is. I love the color palette. Again, the wonderful Autobot symbol. It's even got the little wheels, which are fantastic, guys. This is so well done. I mean, whoever did the art direction for this, I mean, kudos to that guy. That guy needs a raise. You know, in doing this review, I keep looking at this statue over and over again, and I find more things just to admire about it. The lower section, again, just so impressive. And the art style, just look at the boots. The sculpt is fantastic. That is just amazing. The color palette looks great, and it really offsets the rest of the statue. But again, the fact that they put wheels on the actual boots, I mean, guys, come on. That is just freaking awesome. What they did here was great. And I also like the texture. It looks like a kind of felt finish, which is really awesome. Now, you definitely have to mirror this piece because there's so much going on. The hair sculpt, those twin buns look fantastic with the hair strands popping up out of each side. And again, that's supposed to symbolize the Autobots, or Optimus Prime in this case, their horns, the antenna, the twin antennas that he has, which is really cool, guys. That hair sculpt is just amazing. You gotta love the sculpt in the jacket. Again, some really great fan service here. Some of the best I've seen. And then you see how she attaches to the base. Just really awesome, guys. Overall, definitely mirror this piece. So much going on in the reverse side. Probably the most impressive thing about this piece is definitely in the base. It is razor thin, so it has a very thin footprint, which I always like. This iconic Autobot symbol. I definitely love the color palette. You have that gray kind of metal tone offset against the red, which really pops out. If I had one criticism about this base, is that it is very slippery. Maybe you want to put some stoppers on the bottom of it so that it doesn't move around. Some rubber stoppers would do really good because it does twirl around a lot very easily. So that's my only complaint. Other than that, it's a fantastic base. Now, here's the cool thing. You also get an alternate head, which has the actual iconic face shield that's covering Optimus Prime's mouth. If you were a fan of the original design, you'll know what I'm talking about. So you can interchange them and swap them out. The only reason that I didn't actually put it on the head was because it was a little bit hard to do. So be very careful, guys, because what you don't want to do is you don't want to damage it. You definitely want to follow the instructions when swapping out the head here. But it's cool that we get this option, guys. Okay guys, I'm gonna be very honest with you. I probably made a lot of mistakes while I was doing the voiceover for this because I was just gushing over how wonderful, how beautiful, and how just artistically awesome this piece is. In fact, I can't even give it a Holy Grail piece rating because it goes beyond that. This is just a piece that you have to have in your collection. If you're a Transformers fan or if you're an Optimus Prime fan, this thing is a must own, guys, and it goes beyond Holy Grail piece. It's readily affordable, so it's not an issue of the price, but you definitely have to get this in your collection. Get it before it gets to eBay markets, guys, because you're going to pay a lot of money for it. This is simply awesome. I'm also really excited, too, because there is a complimentary piece to this. You're getting a Megatron figure, which is really awesome, guys. If you had a chance to look at the designs of that, it's really cool. I'm going to have it in the studio soon. So be on the lookout for that. Really cool things that Kotobukiya is doing, especially with the Transformers line. And then now we actually have a Bumblebee figure that's going to be releasing later on this year. Just so many cool things, guys. I'm really excited about the fact that they're doing Transformers, which is really awesome. Before I go, I just want to send a special shout out to the folks over at Big Bad Toy Store, especially for keeping me up to date with what's being released and what's being canceled. I really appreciate that. So thank you very much, guys. And if you're interested in this and other collectibles, please visit www.bigbadtoystore.com. All right, everybody. So that's my official review on Kotobukiya's version of Optimus Prime, the Bishojo statue. As always, I thank you for tuning in, and I'll see you on the next Raudeza Reviews. You got the touch. You got the power.